today. XFL Jim here. Father's Day is around the corner. Father's Day just passed, so I thought I'd give us a nice little top 10 list of the best fathers. Top 10 best fathers. Let's get into it. And by the way, we're going a little bit healthier for our snacks this time around. On this top 10 list, I've got this melted Laura bar here that's been in my car for a couple days. At number 10, we've got Morpheus. You know, the dad of the Nebuchadnezzar. Great documentary, The Matrix. It's going to happen here in about, like, maybe this year. So watch out for that shit. But Morpheus, great father figure to Neo, Trinity, Mouse, all those guys, Apoc, Switch, everybody on that ship, he was their daddy. And what better dad to have than a kung fu fighting, no leg glasses wearing son of a bitch who's just a huge badass. Teach you how to use a samurai sword, teach you how to fight, teach you valuable life lessons, and he was a pious man. He was a good figure. You want to mold your life after someone like Morpheus. He was calm, he was collected, he was a wise man, and he was a badass. What more could you want in a dad, really? Number 9, we have me, XFL Jim. I am a father to everyone who loves the XFL. But not only that, I am a father to the LA Wildcats mascot. She is beautiful, she is bold, and I take very good care of her. I teach her valuable life lessons. Teach her how to yell at people, smack people around if they're not paying attention to you. It's extremely important life stuff that I teach. I'm also kind of a better fighter than Morpheus, so it just edges me out that little bit. But remember, these are in no particular order. I'm not saying I'm better than Morpheus. I'm just saying maybe we're equal. You know, me, Morpheus, who can spot the difference, really? Number 8, we have The Rock, Dwayne Johnson. Not only is he a cool dad on Instagram and Twitter, the guy was a father figure to millions who would watch him perform for the WWE. Can you smell what The Rock is cooking? Spoke to me as a child.
The most electrifying line in sports entertainment today, if you smell what The Rock is cooking.
It basically formed my adolescent years. It's what made me the man I am. And I can smell now what he was cooking. He was cooking fatherhood. Man, he's done excellent at it. His beautiful daughters.
I basically feel like The Rock, in some respects, raised me.
Rock, number 8. Number 7, I have Darth Vader, because I believe tough love is an undervalued thing in society today. Sometimes your kid needs to hate you to grow, to get stronger, to figure out who they are. They need to hate something. And as a dad, if you can take that responsibility, more power to you. More people should be fine with getting hate on in this world. Hate me. If it makes you a better person, hate me. Hate the XFL and all its greatness if it makes you better. It's not going to help because the XFL is perfect in every way. But hate what you got to hate. And when Luke was hating on Vader, it made him so much stronger, made him better as a person. I feel like deep down, Vader knew he was doing right by Luke. He was doing right by his son. Getting him to come past that feelings of hate and finally become a man. And isn't that the point of a dad, is to make you a man or a woman? So, Darth Vader, solid dad. Number 6, I've got Sejiro Hiko. He was a father figure to Kenshin. He's the most badass swordsman to ever live. He's ripped. This guy can beat giants. He can kill demons. He can kill anything. He's the ultimate protector. And he doesn't take shit. And as a dad, you can't take no shit. He's a teacher, he's a drunkard, and he's a badass. Three solid dad qualities, and he's an expert in all of them. When he's just going like, I feel that. I feel that in my stomach. Sejiro Hiko, solid dad. Number 5, you have my dad, Papa Jim. Rest in peace. Remember forever. Never forget, Papa Jim. Sadly, passed away 2013 due to a freak bull wrestling accident. That's how he would have wanted to go. Oh, man. Papa Jim did so much for me. Taught me how to shotgun my first beer. Introduced me to hot links. Bathed me in a tub of grits when I was 3 years old. Introduced me to the concept of garage league football, which I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that. Papa Jim, is one of the best dads ever. And through him, I give you your XFL energy. Pour one out for him, everybody. Number four, we got Santa Claus. Now, Santa Claus, I feel, teaches three important aspects when it comes to being a father figure. It teaches you organization, teaches you how to cram, it teaches you caring. The organization, the logistics it takes to give a present to everyone on the planet, even the people who don't believe in you, is insane. Santa Claus is insane. Sometimes your dad teaches you need to ignore your health and personal hygiene in order to get the job done. Santa Claus is gross, people. I feel like we have to have this conversation. If not now, then when? Santa Claus is a disgusting human being, but damn it if he isn't respectable. Maybe that's in spite of it, maybe that's because of it, but I respect him. He's caring, he gives presents to everybody. If you're naughty, you still get coal, which is valuable as hell when you think about it. He's really doing everyone in the world a favor, I gotta say. And then cramming is an important aspect in life nowadays, and Santa's been doing it forever. Sit on your ass 364 days a year, and that one day, just get it all done. Do it all. Santa Claus is a solid dad. Number three, it's gotta be Teddy Roosevelt. This guy is a dad not only to all outdoorsmen, to all Americans, to all beard owners, to all mustache enthusiasts. His kid single-handedly went on to win World War II. Read a book. If you are such a good dad that your kid can single-handedly wipe out an entire army, you raised a badass. If he can take a bullet and keep on trucking for 8 minutes, that's a cool dad move. Theodore Roosevelt, fucking super solid. Number two, I got the Houston Roughnecks for three reasons and three reasons alone. One, June Jones is the head coach. What a dad figure. He's been everywhere. NFL, college football, XFL, Canadian Football League, high school football. He's been a mentor, a father figure. He's been a fucking cool guy. Number two, there's plenty of other dads on that team. Cam Phillips, I imagine, is a dad somewhere. PJ Walker. These guys have kids everywhere. They spread wildfire because they're amazing. Women want to be with them. Men want to be them. Very admirable qualities. And the third reason the Houston Roughnecks are my number two dad, they dad-dicked the entire XFL. Undefeated, number one team. How do you get better than that? And when you're the dad of the XFL, you're the dad of all sports. And if there's not an XFL, please let there be another one. If there's not, though, they're the dad of sports forever. How? You gotta put them on the list. Houston Roughnecks, daddies all around. Now, before I get into my number one, I got a couple honorable mentions. First up, we got Tywin Lannister. An interesting way to go about being a dad. Kind of have your kids fight it out among themselves, and then the strongest comes out. It's kind of like a natural selection of dadding. George Washington, father of America. Not quite as strong as Theo Roosevelt. I mean, Theo had another person in his family become president and be a badass. Never been done before. Haven't been done since. But George Washington, dad of America. Everyone knows the story. He chopped down the tree of England with his wooden dick and then was granted the country of America. Will Smith, you know, selling computers. His kid and him were living in a bathtub, and he made the most out of it. He did right by his kid, the dog. And my last honorable mention, Satan. Finally, we're at my number one dad. For those that know me, it's probably no surprise to who I have here. It's the dude. Now, all these other dads played a crucial part in their kid's life by being there. The dude played the most crucial part in his kid's life by not being in their life at all. The dude recognizes himself as a deadbeat and someone who doesn't want a kid at all and would be a terrible dad. So what does he do? He exits the kid's life. He was put into a situation, unbeknownst to him, by mom, and then he has to make the best of it. He just shoved that situation over there, let the kid be a kid. Let the kid grow up. He doesn't need me. Kids fend for themselves. I would say the same thing if he had left his kid out in the woods. Whoever fucking Mowgli's parents from Jungle Book, great kids. Great parents. And he's also a great bowler, which definitely helps in the category. Bowling's a pretty dad sport. Anyway, those are my top 10 dads of all time. If you disagree with me, you're wrong, but let's have a general healthy discussion here in the comments. Who's your favorite dad? Top 10 lists are pretty fun. I'm going to keep having these videos pump up out of every once in a while. I've got some more cooking videos. I got some more drinks videos. I got some more elegant videos coming your way. Let me know what you want to see down in the comments. And as always, feel free to email me at XFL Jim on Twitter, XFLJim@gmail.com. Hit me up. I'm always available. The Rampage Tour continues. Don't forget about the Rampage. My next video, and that is going to be pretty big one, so be excited for that one when it drops. I hope you guys had a great Father's Day. And without further ado, I bid you all adieu.